We'll hear from Abe Laydon, an elected Douglas County Commissioner in District 1, just elected to his first term, began here in January 2019. Abe's top priorities as County Commissioner include cutting taxes, providing real transportation solutions, ensuring responsible growth, working collaboratively with law enforcement and the school board to make sure we have proven safety solutions ready and in place to protect our kids, and making certain we have clean and abundant air and water for generations to come. Laydon is a proud fifth-generation Coloradan and graduate of Colorado State University and the University of Colorado School of Law. Abe and his wife reside in Lone Tree with their three children, and Abe, if you followed any of the news, was recently a part of the effort in Douglas County to allocate $10 million to schools to improve their school safety, and that's what he's going to be talking about tonight. Let's welcome Abe Laydon.
You know, this is really an exciting night because it was once said that you should never doubt the ability of a small group of people to change the world. In fact, nothing else ever has. I think this group can be a beacon of conservative leadership, and I'm so thankful for my fellow panelists and all of the hard work and dedication that they've put in for years into this particular topic. I think we also need to give a hand for Jeff Hunt's beard. That's fantastic. I did a No Shave November for Men's Health. I think he's been doing No Shave spring, summer, and fall, but I really want to thank him. I want to thank his wife, Nicole Hunt, for serving on our physical school security committee over the summer, and then also a couple of individuals in this room. I come at this very humbly, not as somebody who says he's an elected leader. I'm a public servant. I work for you, not the other way around. I like that you hold government accountable. I'm occupying the government's seat, which is the people's seat for right now, and so I want to be part of this conversation. But as I come at this humbly, I want to really acknowledge Clint Doris, who's in the back. Has had just decades of military experience and served as the chair of our physical school security committee. Obviously, Nicole Hunt. And then also my dear friend Tom Shuffle. I don't know if he's in here somewhere. There he is. So I started my career with Tom Shuffle in the practice of law, gosh, nearly, what, 15, 20 years ago, Tom? And we've had a lot of fun. He teaches business law here, and I remember getting to substitute for him, and it's just fantastic. Anytime I get to come back to CCU, he lets me sometimes judge the mock trials here too, Chuck King, which is a lot of fun. But unfortunately, this year, about mid-April, I put a post on social media. I was recently elected to the office, and one of my commitments was to make sure that no child ever got killed in a school shooting in Douglas County on my watch. And on May 7th, I will never forget getting the text from the undersheriff saying, school shooting, get down to the substation immediately. And my fellow commissioners and I were immediately whisked away to Highlands Ranch right behind the AMC Theater, where we were briefed by the FBI and the sheriff and then pushed out into a press conference. And after we learned that Kendrick Castillo had lost his life trying to save his fellow students, I stepped out of that press conference, took off my badge, took off my coat, and I went across the street to the Northridge Rec Center, where a lot of the students and many of the teachers were huddled and confused and very upset about what was going on. And I said, you know, my thoughts are with you. That did not resonate. I said, I'm sorry. That did not resonate. I was praying for them, which helped a lot, I think, certainly from all of our mutual perspective. Prayer is not the least you can do, it's the most you can do. But what they really wanted were solutions. To my fellow panelists' point, it's been 20 years since Columbine. Certainly not the first school shooting, but probably the most significant on a national stage. And so a lot of folks were saying, okay, enough of the blue ribbon panels, enough of the conversation. What are we actually doing to solve this problem? So I always like to say, you can't spell Douglas County without the words do, D-O. We actually like to get things done, so I give a lot of credit to my fellow commissioners who are not here tonight, Roger Partridge and Laura Thomas, who collectively said right after STEM, we're going to do something. We're not going to wait for anyone to give us marching orders. We're going to reflect the will of the people and get something done. Thankfully, we don't have debt in Douglas County, and through some conservative budgeting over many years prior to me, we were able to appropriate $13.3 million immediately for school safety. And what we did with that was $10 million in one-time funding for physical school security and mental health, $3 million for ongoing funding for SROs, student resource officers, and then $331,000 for a youth CRT program. So in Douglas County, we have what's called the Mental Health Initiative, which has gained some regional notoriety because of the CRT program. And that is where a law enforcement officer rides along with a mental health professional. And if somebody in a mental health crisis calls, they don't get hauled off to jail or diverted into the criminal justice system. They actually get directed to mental health care, which saves a lot of money in government on DA's prosecution and law enforcement. So we're trying to get people the mental health care they need. We've expanded the program to reach youth because a large portion of people that were needing the CRT program were youth. So that was a big part of the process. The other part, we continue to believe as conservatives in Douglas County, all three of us are conservatives and again want to be that beacon of conservative leadership. In Colorado, it's an interesting time here right now, but from our perspective, we believe that the best way to stop a bad guy with a gun is a good guy with a gun. And there is a lot of buy-in in our community for the idea of an SRO, for a trained officer to be in schools. And I love Laura's comment. I would support her on that, the notion of having trained individuals in schools. I think that's a wonderful barrier. But I would also agree with the comment that it is not one solution. I think we're all looking for what is that one thing that's going to solve the problem. Well, the reality is there is evil in the world. Satan is a real, real entity, and we are fighting a spiritual battle on a daily basis, not against flesh and blood, but against these demonic forces. So we know that there is evil, but we can create huge speed bumps to that evil. So it's not just one solution in terms of arming folks, arming trained individuals. It's probably about 20 solutions that we wrap around students to keep them safe. So what we did, again, humbly, we're non-experts. Again, we're holding the people's seat as commissioners. We represent 368,000 people with a $470 million budget. And what we said was, let's get the experts in. So we formed two committees, one of mental health professionals, a 9-member committee, and then a 9-member committee of physical school security experts, including Mr. Doris in the back. And these folks have phenomenal military experience, NASA, Department of Defense, Secret Service. And so throughout the course of the summer, they were charged with the responsibility of providing us with final recommendations for the Board of County Commissioners to appropriate that $10 million in a way that is fiscally appropriate, but also related to actual solutions. We didn't want to fund pea shooters. We didn't want to fund things that were fluff. We wanted to fund things that actually were going to work, that had some evidence and some research behind it. So some of the things I wanted to share are part of the top funding recommendations that we landed upon from our committees. So really the number one is that school building security, having that limited and secured access, physical improvements to the interior, physical improvements to the exterior, door locks, bollards. When you go to Target and you see those enormous balls in the front of Target, those aren't decoration. That's to make sure that a semi doesn't drive through the middle of a school. They're cheap. And that's an easy way to protect our schools, and that's something that our committee has made public in one of our hearings. We've also talked about training for law enforcement, security guards, school personnel, parents, and students. And one of the programs we heard about that I'm a huge fan of is the idea of watchdog dads. And it could be moms too, it can also be grandparents, but it's dads that just have kids in schools. They might have a military background, law enforcement background, but each dad rotates and shows up at school and just walks the halls, greets the students, connects with teachers, and makes it a point to collaborate with the on-site SRO and the security personnel to keep the school safe. That doesn't cost us anything. And we've got amazing grandparents and parents in this community, probably a lot of you with some great background and experience that we'd love to have you employed in that capacity. So something to think about. We also talked a lot about mental health. So there's, of course, the physical building security, there's the SROs, and then there's the mental health issues. We heard a statistic from the University of Colorado Center for Violence Prevention that Dylan Klebold had about 121 red flags of errant behavior before he did what he did at Columbine. So people knew. And if you ask any eighth grade class, who's that one student, who's that one kid that you might be a little worried about? promise you most teachers, most students are going to know exactly who that is. So part of what we'd like to do and what we're funding is curriculum and programming around social emotional learning and mental health, making sure that there's resilience programming in schools and that there's opportunities for schools to identify kids that may have these issues under a rubric of trauma-informed care. And if you're not familiar, trauma-informed care is really around this notion of isolated kids, kids that have parents that are abusing substances, kids from broken homes. They may need to be taught and cared for in a different way than other kids. And flagging those kids ahead of time, not in a way to alienate them, but to identify them, get them the care they need before they're 15 and they become a Dylan Klebold, is part of that solution process. So a couple of the other things, and then I'll move on. How are we doing on time, Jeff?
Good, a few more minutes.
Okay. Yeah. So we also talked about anonymous bystander reporting systems tied to mental health. And you might have heard about text to tip or safe to tell, but these are reporting systems that allow kids to report if they see something that's just off. A kid brings something to school they shouldn't. They talk about, hey, it's an AK-47 type of day. They're able to text that tip or send that message to safe to tell and immediately get a response that's monitored within our community. We want to expand upon that and provide that as another option for kids. And then we also want to make sure that there's communications that are uniform across all schools, making sure that whatever system they're on in terms of radios, apps on their phones, they actually have the same system. They have an alert that every teacher and administrator gets at the same time and they're not disjointed. So, finally, one of the things that's really important to me, two final things. One is, when I first came into office, I came upon the idea of having a three-digit mental health line and didn't get a lot of traction on that until over the summer we heard that Congress has been working with the FCC to actually pass a 988 number, where again, people aren't diverted into the criminal justice system. If you have a mental health issue, anxiety, panic attack, depression, suicidal thoughts, you can call 988 just like you would 911 and get access to a mental health professional. Now the question is, as a fiscal conservative, who pays, how much is it gonna cost? So trust me, we're taking a very hard look at that, but we're working closely with Senator Gardner to advance that. And the final thing I'll touch on, and I know this is a lot, we've been working on this for a while with our experts, but the other idea is around portal security. We would like to do and are exploring a pilot program for innovative technology, including the opportunity to monitor folks as they're coming into a building. I recently was exposed to a program called Athena, which will actually, through the camera system, identify folks that may be approaching the school with a weapon, flag that, photograph it, text that immediately to an SRO, and it comes up as a photo. Because unfortunately, a camera system is usually unmonitored, or can oftentimes be unmonitored by security personnel. So we want to make sure that that gets flagged and could be flagged. So we're looking at that. And then we're also looking at things like MetroSense and a few other programs that have, we've sort of moved on from metal detectors because we constantly hear about the issue of funneling and the issue of not wanting schools to feel like a prison. These systems can be hidden in the walls so you don't see them, or at least camouflaged and vinyled so that they have the school colors on them. They recently were used at the Avengers premiere where Gwyneth Paltrow and Bradley Cooper were walking right through them, barely noticed them. But what they do is they can identify with that ferromagnetic signature potential weapons. So we're looking at some of these solutions, and again, we want them so that people don't have to divest, meaning they can walk right through. So some of these systems can actually process 4,000 people in about 13 minutes. So again, there's no single solution, but we are looking at all of these options to wrap around our kids. So again, thank you for allowing me to be here and looking forward to further questions.